Now we are going to tell our short love story.
So, we met in 2014 when we went for our post-graduation in Delhi. So, he stays in Chandigarh, but he came to Delhi to study further. We were friends for a year, like very good friends. And in 2015, we started liking each other and decided to date. And initially, we thought we shouldn't date because let's not ruin our friendship. But then we just decided to go for it. And it's been 5 years that we've been dating and now we're married.
So we got engaged on 16th of March 2020 and our marriage was supposed to happen and it happened on 2nd May. So on 24th of March, the Janta curfew was announced and everything stood still for a long time. We were waiting for the lockdown to get lifted so that we could plan our marriage accordingly. But
so we decided to wait till 15th of April to further see what the government updates are. And on 16th of April, when the curfew got extended again, we kind of decided that we'll have to, you know, postpone our wedding and we won't be able to do the wedding because since everything is locked down, we couldn't see any way through which we could, you know, possibly go ahead with the marriage. So, but I think luck had something else planned for us. On 1st of May, the day our Sangeet was initially planned, his dad called my parents and said he might be able to, you know, arrange a pass and we can possibly get married the next day. So we were all like extremely shocked and we didn't know what to do. But we just decided to, you know, go for it and see what luck has in store for us. So these guys applied for a pass on 1st. The pass got rejected initially. Then they applied it again. And in the second go, the pass got approved.
So it got approved at around 3:30 p.m. And yeah, so after that, we initially started our
plans.
And we... So she started packing her clothes because she had to move from Delhi to Chandigarh.
Yeah.
And I didn't do initially anything, but then I started to get excited about it because the next day I was getting married and we had to arrange a Panditji. So her mom went to a temple and asked the Panditji to recite the mantras for us. But the Panditji agreed.
Yeah, the Panditji agreed, but then later he said no, because when he went back to his family, his kids sort of said that no, you shouldn't do the ceremony because these guys are traveling from out of state and he wasn't sure how safe it's going to be. So the Pandit then said no at 6 p.m. So my mom just went out again and tried to arrange for another Pandit. So we found a second Pandit at around 7:30 p.m. And finally we knew, okay, another, we went a step ahead and now we'll be able to, you know, maybe have our wedding. So the next steps were to find clothes for the wedding, to finalize decor for the wedding, to finalize a photographer for the wedding and the catering for the wedding. We didn't have any time. And so the clothes that we decided were that I'll wear my mom's sari because I didn't have my wedding lehenga, and he decided to wear
a tuxedo which my mother-in-law gifted me on the engagement.
Yeah, so for the decor we didn't do anything special, just, you know, arrange some flowers and put some nice curtains. That's all we did. For the catering, a few of my relatives stay close by to my house, and since we did not have a lot of time to prepare, we just told them to, you know, arrange for food and, you know, get some lunch prepared. So it was like sort of like a potluck wedding where these guys prepared food and, you know, got it for us. And the last aspect was the photographers. So his brother owns creative films and they were the official photographers for the engagement and for the wedding as well. So we asked him to be there for the ceremony and he got his equipment and they were the photographers.
So the next day, the wedding day, we started at 5 a.m. from Chandigarh and we reached her place at around 9:15 a.m. So she wasn't ready and we reached very early. So we had to reach there by 10. So the Panditji had to come by 10:30. He was punctual and he was there by 10:30. And he started arranging things for the feras and all. At 11 a.m. we started the feras with just 16 people, including the Panditji. So my mother, my father and my brother traveled from Chandigarh to Delhi and we had our ceremony. Her relatives, as she told, her relatives stayed nearby by 5 minutes walking distance. They all came by and all our friends and relatives attended our feras on a Zoom call. So now I'm going to tell about the challenges we had faced during our lockdown wedding. So there were two major there were two major challenges that we faced. First was arranging an interstate pass because we had to travel from Panchkula to Delhi. And the other was to arrange a Panditji. So arranging a Panditji is a big task, guys. Take care of it.
So the last message we have for all the followers out there is that if you want to get married, just go ahead with it. The government has even, you know, eased some regulations. You can get married with 50 people, which we never had the option of. And just go ahead and get your wedding done. Even the vendors now are open, you know, the photographers do come, the makeup artists do come. हमारे पास तो कुछ भी नहीं था गाइस. सो इफ यू वांट टू रियली गेट मैरिड, इट इज पॉसिबल. सो डोंट लेट दीज स्मॉल स्मॉल हिकअप्स यू नो स्टॉप यू फ्रॉम एंजॉयिंग योर बिग डे. सो दैट्स ऑल. बाय
बाय. हे गाइस, आई एम नितिन अरोड़ा एंड शी इज चैताली पुरी अरोड़ा एंड यू गाइस आर वॉचिंग अस ऑन पॉप डायरीज़.